Hey, hello and welcome to our channel, guys. So today in this video we're gonna talking about the top 10 disgusting foods that the Chinese food eat. Well, the locals in many countries consume food that we find to be bizarre, but Chinese has one of the large varieties of food in the world. Walk down any street market in China, you'll find the delicious delicates, the tourist treats, and even the downright disgusting. Some of these dishes are known for their taste, some have been unique, and others for their medical purposes and can be made from animals, plants, insects, and just about anything else. The saying must be true: the Chinese eat everything with four legs except tables and chairs, and everything that flies except aeroplanes. So let's jump into our number 10, which is balut. Balut is a Chinese dish that was adopted by Philippines in 17th century. It is now considered a national dish of the Philippines, but it is a Chinese food, hence its inclusion on the list. According to a study in 2007, Chinese traders and migrants evolved the custom of eating fertilized dog eggs to the Philippines. Around the 17th century, it's said the origin is from Chinese maodan, or feathered egg. Many of us consume eggs in some forms without even questioning it, because they are unfertilized and have many nutritious benefits for our lives. The Chinese, along with other countries, eat eggs in a very different way, known as balut. Balut is partially developed chicken or dog eggs that has been incubated between 14 and 21 days before being boiled and eaten. Balut is a popular street food that can be found in many roadside markets. It may sound sickening to eat a partially developed dog, but this dish is considered a delicacy in many places such as China. The fertilized egg is boiled for about 25 minutes and is eaten while the egg is still warm. The yolk portion is described as rich and creamy with an overall mild taste, and some eggs contain bones and feathers that are edible, which according to local beliefs make the men in them during more masculine. In number 9 in our list, it comes silkworms. Various insects are considered a delicacy in many cultures. In China, silkworms are one of those insects and they are enjoyed by the local. Silkworm poppy remains after their fibrous cocoons have been harvested are used in several different ways of consumption. The flavor is like shrimp or crab and has a chewy consistency. Silkworm can be found in local markets, cooked several ways, or stocked frozen and canned. Chinese style silkworm are added to stir fry with your favorite vegetable, soy sauce, and seasonings. It's normally served with the rice or noodles, or the pupae can be deep fried and served with your choice of dipping sauce. If you are not sold on consuming the insect in your stir fry, you can always start with the sweeter and more tourist friendly version, chocolate covered silkworms. In number 8, it's called sea pennies. If you are looking to boost libido, the Chinese have a bizarre food that may help. Sea pennies, along with other animal pennies and testicles, are served as a remedy for the problems. A restaurant in China is dedicated to serving all types of dishes with animal genitals, such as seed gonads, on a bed of curry and steamed seed pennies. The locals enjoy the flavor of the dish, but they also believe it is good for oneself. Many of the customers at the restaurant are males looking to increase potency and sexual powers. The Chinese believe that they can replenish parts of their bodies by eating dishes with those same body parts, which is why testicles and penis are consumed to improve sexual health. Instead of turning to a pill, try this technique, Chinese dish instead. Number 7, here it's come Pidan. Pidan, also known as century egg, is a traditional Chinese food that boasts a unique color and fragrance. It is usually a dog or chicken egg that is preserved in mixture of clay, ash, salt, and alkaline material. The egg yolk may appear yellow, dark green, or brown depending on the processing time, but the center is normally soft in all colors, refreshing, smooth, delicious, and salty are words that normally describe the unique food. During the process of making these eggs, the chemical reaction turns the egg white to transparent, and a slow flake pattern may be visible on the outside. Pidan can be preserved up to 5 months if the eggshell remains unbroken. They can be served in cold dishes such as a salad, or can be paired with soy sauce and green chilies for a spicy lunch. Century eggs are also popular gifted for friends and family during the traditional Chinese Dragon Boat Festival. In number 6, here it comes the bird's feet soup. One of the more controversial bizarre foods the Chinese eat is bird's nest soup. The famous soup is made from swiftlet's actual nest. The small bird is found in Southeast Asia and lives in dark caves like a bat. Their nest are made from their own gloomy saliva produced by the glands under their tongue. The nest of saliva harness as it exposed to the air. The commonly way to cook bird's nest soup is slowly steaming it after soaking it in water. The texture of the nest is soft like jelly, but it doesn't have much taste. The taste is not what keeps locals coming back each every day for the soup, but it is the benefits that attracts Chinese. If the soup is consumed regularly, it is believed to help maintain youth and promote a healthy life and strong body. In number 5, here it comes the scorpions. Those looking for something crazy to snack on while walking the streets of China may find scorpion to be tasty treat. These small scorpions are fat and short on a stick. They can be found on the street of popular cities to lure tourists into trying something local and bizarre. Since the scorpions are thin, they turned into crispy with the nice seasoning. It is believed that eating scorpions can cure certain medical conditions and can make the blood hotter in cold conditions. In number 4, here comes stinky tofu. One of the most popular snacks in China is stinky tofu. The smell of the popular street food can be spotted from a block away, maybe even further. The traditional dish is tofu fermented in a mixture of milk and vegetable, meat and fish based brine or combination of these ingredients. It is usually deep fried in vegetable oils and served with chili and soy sauce and soaked in small squares covered together and served on a plate. It can also be found steaming, stewed or soaked in soup. Biting into stinky tofu feels like biting into a piece of soft cheese and taste best when served with sauce or toppings. If you want to know where to find it, simply follow your nose. In number 3, here it comes the chicken testicles. KFC offers several types of chickens on the menu, but you'll have to search other places in China to find chicken testicles. These juicy delicates are said to enhance male powers to improve a woman's skin tone. They are available in both pink and black, and their size range anywhere from 1 to 2 inches long. Their casing contains flesh, making them like little sugar cakes. They are lightly cooked to keep them tender and juiced with holes into your mouth. As you take the first bite, after boiling or frying the chicken testicles, they will offer you a mild flavor and are best served with rice, noodles or even both. In number 2, here it's come the fried seahorse. A seahorse is one of the cutest small marine fish found in the sea, but it is also found on China street as a snack. Seahorse has a liquid-like consistency and it is very salty. They are mostly found in soup or on kabobs and found in several street markets. You must be careful when consuming seahorse though, because they have sharp pieces that can get caught in your gums or teeth. The Chinese also believe that there are great benefits of eating seahorse. One Chinese proof says that eating seahorse can keep an 80 years old granddad young. Many locals use it as an ancient Chinese medication for energy and boost sexual performance. They can be mixed with herbs and boiled as tea to treat asthma and male sexual dysfunction. Unfortunately, it appears the seahorse numbers are declining due to high demand. In number 1, here it comes the tortoise shell jelly. Turtle jelly or tortoise jelly, also known as yulinago in Chinese jelly like dessert. It is traditionally made from various types of turtle bottom shells and several herbal products. Most turtle jelly comes from commonly available turtle species to keep the price down, but some extremely expensive options are available are made using ingredients from the golden coin turtle. Some turtle jelly on the market doesn't even include any ingredients from turtle anymore. This delicacy is also used for the medical purpose in China. It is said to be able to improve circulation, assist muscle growth and restore kidney functions. Many believe that regular consumption of turtle jelly can improve skin by giving it healthier complexion. It usual dark brown or black in color or slightly bitter, but many sweeteners can be added to improve its taste. Here is another interesting item which will be waiting for, and it's the bat soup. Under the circumstances, it will be remiss to be exclude bat soups from this list. And while it is unlikely that the bat eating is a cause of the current coronavirus situation, it has certainly been pushed well into the spotlight as a reason that bat placed on a soup bowl after boiling with chicken broth. The bat is decreased with a knife and fork, and the wort is then eaten with a spoon along with the innards of the creature. Air is present in the dish along with the membranes of the bat wings. The dish is allegedly rather delicious, but we are forced to conclude that it is very unappetizing to see an entire bat floating in front of us. The bat are also capable of carrying a number of human transmissible diseases, and the practice is considered unsuitable by many conversation organizations. It is these are the top 10 most disturbing and disgusting foods that China and Chinese people should eat. If you like this video helpful, please share with your friends and family, and please give this video a thumbs up and do subscribe to our channel for more interesting stuffs like this.